Lady Railsplitter volleyball team returns to the Mary E. Mars Gymnasium tonight as they host the Cobras from Coker College out of Hartsville, South Carolina. And that's a mouthful to say, Coach, but I'll tell you what, I know you're glad to be home again.
It is. It just really makes me think of that whole dodgeball, the, you know, kind of thing, and we were just doing that beforehand. So
you're coming into this one on a very tough stretch for your team this year, one in which you've lost several straight. But if there's a positive to be pulled out of that, your most recent match over Jefferson City, you and I had a brief time to talk before we took the air, and I felt like your team went over there and really, really played hard.
We did. We competed, and we showed a lot of heart and a lot of fight. You know, we're a very good team, and we tell our girls that, and they know it, and they believe it, and we're working hard. We're getting better. We're just struggling right now to get all facets moving in the same direction at the same time. You know, we'll have a couple miscues by our offense, and our defense is playing well. Then we'll have a couple miscues by our defense. Then, you know, maybe we'll have a breakdown in serve receive. And we just are really working hard to improve, getting all areas doing well at the same time. And when that happens, we're going to be real scary.
We've seen over your tenure as head coach, various teams throughout the league drastically improving. No longer is it just Wingate at the top of the heap. They're still there, but the teams are closing the gap. In the past, Tusculum under Coach Robinson's direction has been one of those teams. Now, over the last couple of years, Carson Newman has really come along strong. And to go over there and play the Eagles at 7-1 on the year, their record 7-1 in Holt Fieldhouse as closely as we did, it's not a win, but it's still a huge feather in your cap.
It is. You know, we were on a pretty bad skid there, you know, losing three in a row. I think it might have been actually the first time that we lost two in a row and in a weekend since I've been here. So that was really tough. And, you know, we just kind of rallied together on Monday before practice, and we talked about some things, and it was really good. We had really good morale, and we had a great practice on Monday. And, you know, our mindset going in on Tuesday was, if we're going to go down, we're going to go down swinging. We're going to be aggressive. We have nothing to lose and everything to gain. And, you know, right now Carson Newman is atop the conference record-wise as well, because Wingate dropped a match to LR. And we knew we had the opportunity to compete and play well and just fight and give heart, and that's what we did.
Big weekend coming up for you, and obviously you have to start with first thing first. Coker comes into the house Friday evening. That's tonight, obviously. Then you've got the nationally powerhouse, ranked powerhouse Wingate tomorrow. But while that might be in some of your girls' mind, I know you well enough to know that you're keeping them focused on tonight's match.
Absolutely. We have to go day by day. You know, we're trying to get better every day. We're trying to improve. And we have so much on our side of the net that we're trying to get better at and just get in sync and be going in the right direction. As I mentioned earlier, that you know, we have been, you know, taking Coker very seriously. They have a new coach, you know, a young lady who came from the Johnson City area who's going to be doing a nice job and already has done a nice job over there. So they're fired up. They're fired up. They're playing well. They're doing much better. You know, starting the preseason, I think they were actually leading the conference in non-league play as far as record-wise, you know, in the opening weekend. They've been doing very well. So they've had some success. They're doing some nice things, and we need to come to play tonight.
You talked about working on serve receive and some of the other things. Specifically, what are the things that you've worked on this week since the match with Carson Newman in preparation for these two, in particular tonight against Coker?
We've been focusing on providing our offense, even when we're out of system, better balls. So even if we can't have Abby Cash running the show and setting up good tempo offense, being able to still effectively run out of system and have an opportunity to score.
Obviously, Coker is a team that is under new direction, as you've already pointed out, but one that really, when you go out on that road in that scenario, you know that you gotta pull one, two matches. And I think their travel partner Wingate probably plays Carson Newman tonight, and, mm-hmm. and of course they'll go there tomorrow, so they know they've got to salvage at least one out of this trip. And, you know, folks, we got them here tonight in the Mary E. Mars Gymnasium. It's not too late to come on out and support this Lady Railsplitter team. They need your support. And, Coach, I know that opening weekend had some great fan support here.
Absolutely. Our weekday games have been with great attendance. And on Saturdays, you know, the pep band has been there, and they've been doing a great job creating an awesome atmosphere for us. And we look forward to seeing everybody coming out tonight.
What do you think the keys will be very quickly?
Ball control. serve and serve, receive, and offensively being able to eliminate our errors.
All right, Coach, good luck.
Thank you.
All right, Lady Railsplitters coming up next against the Cobras. Stay with us here on the LMU Sports Network.
Make K&K Metal Sales your only stop for all your residential and commercial metal building needs. For the past 23 years, K&K Metal Sales has covered the tri-state area with quality custom roofing and siding with many grades, gauges, and colors in stock. If you're looking for complete steel or wood building packages or steel or wood trusses, K&K Metal Sales can help with that, as well as heavy-duty custom carports. Great folks and great prices. Stop by K&K Metal Sales located at 6986 Cumberland Gap Parkway or call 423-869-4261.
From commercial to residential, from the basement to the attic, Knoxville Drywall can deliver full-service drywall, insulation, and paint contracting. Knoxville Drywall specializes in new and tenant buildouts, drywall repair, drywall grids, metal stud framing, acoustical ceilings, suspended drywall ceilings, and ceiling and wall texturing and painting. Knoxville Drywall also provides wall-blown insulation for existing walls, attic-blown insulation, wall and ceiling bats insulation, and crawlspace insulation. Knoxville Drywall Incorporated, serving Knoxville and the surrounding area for more than 56 years with outstanding quality and competitive pricing.
Welcome back to the Mary E. Mars Gymnasium. Rusty Peace, Mike Smith here with you tonight. Mike, Coker College, a team that comes in to tonight's match at 2-5 on the year. They're still looking for their first South Atlantic Conference win. LMU at 1-4, so not two of the teams that are the hotter teams in the league right now, but sometimes you get some distance separation at this point in the year when you get two teams like this squaring off.
Yeah, if you look at Coker's roster, they have one senior on the team. The rest are freshmen, sophomores, and at this point, you know, they're still probably finding themselves as well, and coming on the road, sometimes that's not an easy task, especially in this league.
Well, the Lady Railsplitters, as we said, are in need of a shot in the arm tonight, and you know, no better time to get it. They've got an angry dog coming in here tomorrow afternoon. That's without a doubt when Shelton Collier and his Bulldogs come into the house to take on this Lady Railsplitter team. But as you heard Jenny Michael say in the pregame, you got to take first game first. And, you know, right now we've got a pretty good crowd filing in here tonight, some of the student bodies on hand. Oddly enough, it's a Friday night. Mike, we don't have that pep band again in here, and we thought that we would have it in here tonight.
I think they'll be here tomorrow.
Well, that'll be a welcome addition to the starting lineup or to the match tomorrow. But in addition to the serve and receive, Mike, you've seen this team play a couple of times. What do you see are essential things that this team's got to do well tonight in order to come away with a win?
I think the biggest issue or the biggest thing needs to happen is not give away free points. When you're having issues or having mishaps with the serve and with the pass, you just can't give away those free points. You got to make teams earn them and not give them, you know, as you try to say, sometimes bonus points. And you want to make a team earn those points. And I think if the ball control is there and you minimize the serving errors, you know, good things are going to happen. You're giving yourself a great opportunity to have good things happen.
Well, everybody healthy in the lineup right now, obviously. And this team really surprised me somewhat on Tuesday when they went over to Jefferson City, Tennessee, and played Carson Newman as closely as they had. It would be easy for a team to fold the tents on a run like they've had, but this team went over there and laid it all on the line and really took that thing right down to the wire.
Yeah, they played, you know, they had an exceptional night and led late in the fifth set, just unfortunate not to come away with a win at Holt Fieldhouse.
We're going to go ahead and run down the starting lineup for Coker. We don't have the Lady Railsplitter starters yet, so the Coker lineup tonight, it'll be Kristen Bragg. She's the setter, 5'10", and a sophomore out of Boynton Beach, Florida. At the outside hitter position, Kaylee Gunter. She is a 5'8 freshman outside hitter, as we said, from Johnsonville, South Carolina. Alexis Burles will start at the middle hitter right side position, 5'10", a sophomore out of Granville, Michigan. Madison Bingle will start at outside hitter, a 5'9 sophomore out of Grand Rapids, Michigan. Shaylen Miller will start at middle hitter, a 6'1 sophomore from Campton Hills, Illinois. And it will be Megan Hardy at the right side, 5'11, a sophomore out of Lancaster, New York. And it is, you want to pronounce this last name for me, Mike?
Julia Rafalowski.
Julia Rafalowski. That is one of the tougher coaches' names that I've run into in several years. But she is the head coach of the Coker Cobras. And again, they are out of Hartsville, South Carolina. We're going to take a brief pause. When we come back, we'll run down the Lady Railsplitter starters right after this on the LMU Sports Network.
Known for his purpose, his determination, and his ability to see a path laid before him and step into it with utmost certainty. At Lincoln Memorial University, we recognize those who do the same, The few who, in the face of adversity, choose destiny over indifference. Like Lincoln, they stand apart. And here is where they hang their hat. Lincoln Memorial University. Your career path is here.
The quarter pounder with cheese. A juicy, simply seasoned patty seared to perfection. Having one next to you can be a little distracting. In fact, it's so beefy and cheesy that... wait a minute. What was I just saying?
Now at McDonald's, get two classic quarter pounders with cheese for only $4. Two great sandwiches for a price you'll be loving.
Welcome back. Let's run down the Lady Railsplitter starting lineup for tonight. First of all, it'll be Liz Brock at outside hitter, 5'10", and a redshirt junior out of Lima, Ohio. Kiara Holland makes the start at outside hitter, 5'9", a sophomore from Columbia, South Carolina. Erica Whitaker will start at the defensive specialist position, 5'3", a freshman out of Kingston Springs, Tennessee. Jazzy Oates at the middle blocker, 5'8", a senior out of Franklin, Tennessee. Brooke Fleeman starts on the right side, 5'10", and a junior out of Nashville, Tennessee. Abby Cash playing center and right side, 5'10", a junior out of New Carlisle, Ohio. And Tone Gill will start at middle hitter, 5'9", and a redshirt freshman out of Nashville, Tennessee. Mike, that's the starting lineup tonight. I'll tell you, I've said it before, I'll say it again. I really like this Erica Whitaker. She is a spark plug on the defensive end of the floor.
Yeah, you like a motor on the floor, and she definitely brings some energy and spirit to the group.
All right, we got a little special occasion going on here tonight. They're recognizing some of the faculty and staff here from the campus. And, Mike, this is something new that has been brought to the table. Tell us a little bit about this whole exchange right here.
Well, I think that they wanted to do a faculty-staff appreciation night, and the players had people that they, I guess they nominated that they went to, and it's great to see such a turnout here tonight and allow the allow everybody to see them.
Yeah, Dr. Sylvia Lynch, Whitney Bailey of the LMU Athletic Training Department, Dr. Karen Carter is being introduced, Dr. Jason Fowler, Dr. Celeste, and how do you pronounce that last name?
Weave.
Weave, okay. All right, Dr. Celeste Weave, Dr. Catherine Benson, Dr. Lee Gilroy will be here tonight as well, Dr. Jason Fowler, Dr. Jessica Cave, Dr. Catherine Pebworth, or K-Peb, or Dr. Pebber, or whatever we call her here. She's at all the LMU sporting events. Dr. Elizabeth Thompson is one of the individuals being recognized. Dr. Aggie Vanderpool, and, of course, the athletic training clinical instructor, Whitney Bailey, who was already mentioned a minute ago. I don't know why they've got her on there twice. Mike, the schedule for the Lady Railsplitters, is just as brutal as the rest of the conference, and I guess that works in reverse, too. You got Wingate tomorrow. You're lucky enough to play several more home matches. You got Anderson coming in here, followed by Newberry, Mars Hill. Then you go out on the road for a three-match road swing that'll take you through another league with Francis Marion Lander and USC Aiken. Kind of an odd place to stick that non-conference play right in the middle of the season.
Well, I think the thing that you look at here with that is it's a good mid-season test. You're going against the Peach Belt Conference, who's going to be, region opponents, and for two out of three of the matches will be on a neutral site. So, it'll give you a different look before you hit the second part of conference play.
Just dawned on me, Mike. I know we've been through the starting lineup already, but I've noticed Casey Mincy is not making the start tonight. Do we know, is Coach Michael trying to send her a message? Is somebody else just playing better than her at this point?
No, I have no concept with what's going on there.
All right, well, the introductions are still taking place along with the recognition of some of the faculty and staff here at Lincoln Memorial, and that is all part of some new things that are going on here in terms of athletics. Want to remind you that the Lady Railsplitters will be on the air again tomorrow afternoon when they take on Shelton Collier and the Bulldogs. So those of you at home watching the broadcast tonight, whether it be here on local cable or through the World Wide Web, you can catch pregame coverage beginning at about 1:50 here on the LMU Sports Network. Mike Smith and I will have the call. And then, of course, at 2 o'clock we'll have first serve. Mike, I know that you're probably pretty happy that this match will be probably over by the time the Cats get on the air tomorrow night against Missouri.
Yeah, trying to get back on track here. Lost a tough one last weekend. Defense played well. Got to find some offense.
Well, I wasn't going to go there, but now that you brought it up, I'm just going to say it like it is. Mike, I'm going to tell you right now, the defense against Florida absolutely played their hearts out a week ago. They gave up one touchdown. We lost 14-9. The offense gave up the other touchdown. And to be quite honest with you, you know, were it not for our field goal kicker, it could have been really, really ugly. But I agree with you. I mean, Boom is not going to be able to run the ball every down. You've got to find some variety in that offense, keep the defense honest. And I'm not a Patrick Toles fan. I'm really not.
Well, I think the biggest issue right now, you've either got to get some confidence or you got to make a switch. And I'm not sure that this weekend's probably the best move with Missouri having such a strong defense. I think they're one of the top in the SEC. So, you know, it's probably a big weekend for him as much as anybody, because as you're getting ready to head into Eastern Kentucky non-conference, you know, you could always go a different direction if need be.
I think the Vols are playing Florida, but that's next week, isn't it?
No, tomorrow.
They're playing tomorrow. Okay, well, I understand that's a late afternoon game. And, of course, the Cats get underway somewhere around 7 o'clock, 7:30 tomorrow night. All right, we're going to take a timeout. When we come back, we'll have your opening serve. This is the LMU Sports Network.
It's the Old Town Grill.
The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family, more than friends. Bring a hearty appetite, because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
Whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Subway of Harrogate and Middlesbrough has your fresh interest at heart. On your way to work, try one of our mouth-watering breakfast sandwiches or flatbread omelets. If it's lunch or dinner you're after, choose from a wide selection of classic, select, or premium sandwiches that are all made specifically to order. Serving a crowd, Subway also has sandwich platters, giant subs, box lunches, and even cookie platters. Be it dine in or carry out, you can eat healthy and eat fresh at Subway. 368 Catawba Avenue in Harrogate and on the corner of the Village Square Mall, Middlesbrough.
Whether institutional case good or architectural woodwork, Nolan Products Incorporated of Knoxville has been serving East Tennessee, Southwest Virginia, and Southeast Kentucky since 1958. From concept to finish, Nolan Products custom builds to the highest quality standards to meet your facility specifications while using only the finest materials available. Nolan Products has been serving and meeting the needs and requirements of general contractors and architects in East Tennessee and surrounding area for more than 55 years. Nolan Products Incorporated, 912 Forsyth Street, Northeast, Knoxville.
Pinnacle Performance Physical Therapy wants you to know you have a choice where to receive physical and occupational therapy. We take an individualized approach to treating people of all ages. Our therapist's goal is to assist all patients by reaching their pinnacle performance in school, work, and play. We have state-of-the-art equipment such as our Alter-G anti-gravity treadmill, used to rehabilitate injuries and pain throughout the body's lower extremities. Contact us for an appointment at 423-869-9923. Pinnacle Performance Physical Therapy, 362 Catawba Avenue,
Welcome back. We are just about set to get underway here in Harrogate, Tennessee, as the Lady Railsplitters square off against Coker College for the first time this year. Of course, they will have another match later on in the season. That'll be down in Hartsville, South Carolina on the 30th of October, so a little bit more than a month from now. That'll be a night game as well. That'll be one night shy of the Halloween festivities. I think Halloween this year is on a Saturday. Yeah, so that'll be interesting. They go to Wingate for that Halloween trick-or-treat match over there in North Carolina. All right, we are set to get underway. Lady Railsplitter and Railsplitter soccer teams on the road tomorrow over in Hickory, North Carolina, taking on Lenoir Ryan University, both trying to bounce back after tying this past week. And that was kind of a surprise.
Yeah, they battled hard this week.
All right, Abby Cash will have the opening serve of the match. LMU on the right wearing the white tops. And Coker on the left in the gold and navy blue tops. Way to the back row, Whitaker answers. Here's a set to the near side and the tip over that time by Brock of Lincoln Memorial. Jenny Michael very happy with the effort that she got from her team over in Jefferson City despite the loss. Here's Brock on the attack. Hard angle falls into play, and that's the way we wanted to see him start.
Net friendly right there. Brock with that quick wrist snap.
Take a little bit of luck any day. Abby Cash holding serve side out to Lincoln Memorial. Serve to the deep back row. Set to the middle. There's the LMU block. That was Fleeman and also Tone Gill that got up for the block assist.
Yeah, anytime that you can go ahead and get penetration over the net and see that hitter, That's big for Fleeman.
Cash holding serve deep to the back line again, just off the stripe. And that'll give it to Coker for the first time as they get their first sub into the lineup. Missy Reed will check in. She's a libero, 5'5", and a sophomore out of Boynton Beach, Florida. She has the serve. First time Lincoln Memorial has received in this set. 2-1, LMU. Cash sets middle. Gill tips it to the back row. Set to the far side on the attack this time for Coker. It was Bingle. And LMU hits it out of play.
Fleeman just a little late on snapping that wrist.
Two all. As Coker holds serve. Whitaker receives. Cash sets for Brock. Blocked back. Nice dig by Whitaker. Fleeman on the attack. Set to the near side. That was Hardy, I believe, that came charging in. And LMU falls behind for the first time in this set. 3-2, Cobras with the lead.
Hardy comes in at 2.2 kills a set for the Cobras.
Short serve received there by Holland. Fleeman trying to go down line, hits it out, and that'll give a 2-point cushion to the Cobras.
Yeah, Fleeman had a big night in Jefferson City.
Again, the short serve, Holland receives. Cash with the dump, and really nobody home right there. Mike, I know that a lot of teams look at game film and so forth. Is that something that's really done a whole lot in volleyball? Do you take your team in and watch a team's tendencies?
Absolutely. You gotta know, for the most part, you got to know what you're looking at.
LMU block really getting up at the net right there. Cash to Brock. Now Fleeman will attack. Dig back there. I think that was Waters that got a piece of it. And LMU will get credit for the point on that miscue.
Yeah, Gill with the block that time, really going pin to pin.
Ties the match again at four, the set rather. Here's Brock on the jump serve. Waters answers back there, a couple of poor recoveries, but they did get it across. Here's Cash setting middle. Nice swing that time by LMU's Tone Gill.
She gets up and hangs in the air, and that block sometimes just doesn't have an answer for her.
Lady Railsplitter's back out on top by one. Brock serve to the back row, and that is tipped out of play. So LMU comes storming back to take a 2-point lead here in the opening set of tonight's match. There's a big match going on over in Jeff City here tonight. Very short serve by Brock. Carson Newman playing host to Wingate, the two unbeatens in the league. Mike, that is a doozy over there.
Yeah, that's a big match. Actually, Wingate has a loss, Rusty.
In conference
to Lenore Ryan.
Well, I did not know that. I beg your pardon. Last I looked, they were 7-1. I did not know that loss was to Lenore Ryan. Six all as Coker has come storming back. Tough ball at the net. Nice dig out of there by Gill after the joust. And a good attack for Coker's Madison Bingle, the 5'9 sophomore of Grand Rapids, Michigan. She'll get credit for the kill. 7-6, Cobras now with side out. Short serve, Whitaker gets under it. Set for Holland, across the grain and in on the back line.
You give her a little bit of room on that block and she's just gonna blast the seam.
Yeah, she struggled with that diagonal hit a couple of times this year in the home matches we've seen, Mike, but that one looked really good.
Yeah, sometimes she can get a little too sharp with her angle.
Bad reception by the Cobras, and just like that, we're tied again at 8. Or maybe it's 7. Set to the middle. Whitaker hits it flat off the hands. Holland trying the hard angle. There's what we're talking about.
Sometimes she can get a little too severe with that angle, too sharp.
Entering for the Cobras, Kara Overholt. She's a 5'9 freshman out of Tyron, North Carolina. And she'll have the serve for the Cobras from Coker. 8-all. Serves on its way. Brock receives. Cash sets backside for Fleeman right down on the downswing.
Nice set by Cash. The block was a little late, and Fleeman made him pay.
Fleeman earns the serve on that one as LMU goes back out on top by one. Close set here thus far. Nobody able to put any distance between the other. Set to the near side on the attack for Coker. It is Bingle, and she'll tie it up again at nine apiece. Bristol Snyder entering for Lincoln Memorial. She's a defensive specialist setter, 5'6", and a junior from Chattanooga, Tennessee. Played at Walker Valley High School. Serves on its way. Whitaker keeps it alive. Nice effort by Cash to do so. It was a tough one to dig out of the nylon. Whitaker to Cash. Cash back set for Oates on the run. She was rejected. Here's Brock off the back row. That was a nice swing. Brock had the dig, but she hit a laser right at Snyder, and Snyder too close to her to respond.
Yeah, both teams really, really blasted each other.
10-9. Cobras with the lead and side out, and that went off the back line, and we're tied again at 10-all. Mike, I tell you, again, good fan support here tonight. If you have that pep band in here, I think things are kind of lively.
Absolutely. It's, you know, it's one of those things for the – for the home matches the Lady Railsplitters have had this year. They've had great support.
Here's Holland on serve for Lincoln Memorial. Set to the far side. The attacker is Gunter, and that'll be a kill for the Cobras as Gunter gets the swing and the point.
Yeah, she put it right in the deep corner, hard to defend.
Side out again to Coker. 11-10, Cobras lead it. Snyder and Holland combined, set to the middle for Brock. Brock got a piece of it. Was it tipped, Mike?
No, it came off the top of the net again.
It looked like after it hit the net that it went out on the far side. Must have been in.
Yeah, it landed in. Looks like we got somebody going after a camera.
Camera took a hit. Uh-oh. Don't want that. Snyder with a nice dig. Cash sets back row for Oates. And a poor swing that time by Coker's Madison Bingle. And with that, LMU goes up again by one.
Yeah, Jazzy Oates finding a nice hole in the defense there from
keeping
the back row.
Keeping it really close here tonight, Mike. Tipped across, Cash with a dig. And I'll tell you, Tone Gill, she had eyes about the size of golf balls just now as she took a swing at that one on that back row and couldn't keep it in.
Yeah, she saw that ball tight and she was going to swing.
Tied up 12 apiece, side out going to the Cobras. This is Kristen Bragg on the serve. Whitaker steps up on it. Cash with the dump. This time won't work for LMU. Joust at the net. Holland will get it up there. Here's Brock. Tipped across. Cash setting for Brock. On the downswing. Nice swing.
Wow.
We've not seen a whole lot like that this year. Here's another one by Brock. And this time a solo block by Coker's Megan Hardy, a 5'11 sophomore out of Lancaster, New York.
Yeah, unfortunately, Hardy made the adjustment there as Brock ripped two down the line.
13-12, Cobras lead it by one. They've got side out. Long serve to the back row. Holland answers. Snyder and Cash go up. Brock on the attack. Joust at the net. Tone Gill using that jumping ability to send it home.
Yeah, that's not a whole lot you can do right there.
Brooke Fleeman entering for Lincoln Memorial. Fleeman had the start tonight, 5'10 and a junior from Nashville. Set for Gunter. Whitaker answers. Here's Fleeman on the attack, trying to go back line and does. You can see her. She was locating when she went up, Mike. She knew it was open.
Yeah, and instead of going up and ripping it, she had a nice little push that time.
14-13, Lincoln Memorial. Set to the far side, pushed across by Hardy. Brock keeps it alive on a great effort. Fleeman going to the back corner. Got him off balance, and they couldn't do anything with it.
Yeah, nobody home on that one. I think when the ball went to the floor, they just didn't react.
Been a while since LMU led by two. It's 15-13. To the back corner. Set to the near side again for Gunter. And that went off the LMU block and down on the floor. So that'll go back to Cobras as they will have side out. Missy Reed comes back in to do the honors. And we've got a one-point set with LMU on top. Short serve. Holland steps up on it. Cash will set middle. Tone Gill on the downswing, but rejected back. Whitaker, great effort. Hardy up to Bragg. Back to Hardy. Cash with the answer dig. Here's Brock, and she's rejected. That is Hardy, and the block assist to Alexis Burles.
Yeah, they just kept moving and really did a nice job at the net. Brock not able to get away from the block.
15 all, side out stays with the Cobras. Going right at Holland. Here's Cash. Set for Gill, and I mean, looked like she almost bombed the ball and sent it down, Mike.
Yeah, she beat that block, and
wow. She just hangs in the air. Tremendous jumping ability.
They had no answer for that.
16-15. Set to the far side. On the attack and getting the kill is Madison Bingle. And just like that, neither team give it up an inch. They're just back and forth, back and forth. Alexis Burles on serve now for Coker. Brock to Cash. To Gill. And Gill really punishing that front row right there from the middle of the net.
Yeah, she did a really nice job with the quick wrist snap, beating the block, and Tone just seems to be gaining confidence all the time.
Long serve to the deep corner. Set over there for Bingle. Brock keeps it alive. Looked like it was on its way to the floor. Here's Holland across the grain. And really, to be honest with you, Missy Reed did all she could do with that when she was backpedaling on it and made an odd stab at it.
Yeah, when she made the play, everybody just kind of looked at her instead of going and being aggressive to the ball.
LMU again by two, 18-16. Set to the middle. The LMU block is there, but nice response by Coker. Holland to Cash, back set for Fleeman. Across the grain, that one off the ceiling, and that'll be in for the point. Not a whole lot you can do about that. Timeout now taken by the Cobras as LMU has gone up by three for the first time, 19-16. We're back in 1 minute here on the LMU Sports Network.
Whether traveling for business or pleasure, Sleep Inn and Suites of Middlesbrough, Kentucky invites you to dream better here. Located at the foothills of the Cumberland Gap, Sleep Inn and Suites offers luxurious rooms equipped with microwave fridge combo, desk, ergonomic chair, wireless internet, and 32-inch flat-screen TV. While staying with us, visit our fitness center, wake up to our complimentary hot breakfast bar, or have a bedtime snack with our fresh-baked cookies. Sleep Inn and Suites, located off Highway 25E, Middlesbrough.
Mike, let's go back to the lineup that we've got in there tonight. I'm going back to Tone Gill. I mean, she's 5'9". I think that's a generous estimation on her height. But you typically don't see somebody of her stature, or at least I don't, play in the middle hitter position. But with her leaping ability, it really makes up for that lack in height.
Yeah, I think her quick jumping and lateral movement at the pin, at the net, really allows her to go pin to pin. And sometimes you go with quickness over size.
When you can hang in the air as long as she does, you've got a real opportunity to get up there and kind of look things over on where you want to send that ball, I guess.
Yeah, she's formidable at the net.
Here's Whitaker's serve, 19-16 Lincoln Memorial. Hit across from the back row by Reed. Cash will set middle for Oates. Dug up and out of there by Waters, set to the far side. Across the grain and out of play by Madison Bingle. And LMU has put a little distance between them and the Cobras, but still a long way to go. Here's Waters. And that one will fall in play for Coker.
Yeah, not a lot you can do on that one. Unfortunately, that time the net went against us.
Kara Overholt coming back in now for Coker. And she'll step back there to serve. 2017 Lincoln Memorial side out to the Cobras. Whitaker receives. Poor reception. Cash keeps it alive, and Whitaker will hit it over. Set to the far side. On the attack again is Bingle. Set to the middle. Oates with a pretty good swing, but kept alive by the Cobras. Unfortunately, four hits, or at least into the net there. It would have been four. And LMU goes back up by four as Bristol Snyder will return. Brooke Fleeman comes out of the lineup.
Sometimes those unforced errors can be very costly.
21-17, side out with LMU. Here's Snyder's serve, short. Hit across, Whitaker responds. Cash with the dump down the line. And again, just court awareness, Mike.
Absolutely, as they're moving around, you know, Cash has got a, Cash has got a nice volleyball IQ.
22-17. Set to the far side. Hit across with not a lot on it by Bragg. There's Oates again into the block. And Oates will get credit for the kill. Actually, that attack a minute ago that I thought was Bragg was actually Bingle. We've got our second timeout by the Cobras. 23-17 Lincoln Memorial. Back after this with more on the Lincoln Memorial University Sports Network.
From sales to service, online or in person, Anchor Marine of Speedwell, Tennessee is the source for all your boating needs. We carry a wide selection of new and used products and services for Alumacraft, Aqua Patio, Hurricane, Party Craft, Polar Craft, Rinker, Sandpan, and Sweetwater Boats and Pontoons, as well as a full line of Yamaha Marine Engines and Minn Kota Trolling Motors. From bow to stern, Anchor Marine also carries a wide selection of boating accessories. And if it's service you need, we offer on-site factory-trained technicians that are among the best in East Tennessee. Anchor Marine, 6630 General C.W. Steiner Highway, Speedwell.
Welcome back. Rusty Peace, Mike Smith here with you tonight as the Lady Railsplitters play what is pretty much their second home weekend of the year. And they've got five straight here at LMU that starts tonight. And we'll end with Mars Hill coming up a little bit later on. That'll actually be the 6th of October. Set for Holland, and Holland cranking it up from the left side tonight, Mike. She's about 2 for 3 from this angle.
Yeah, she's just powering over the top of the block. And, you know, when you're able to get stay in system, Cash is really putting the ball in a good spot.
Set point. Cobras have to have this one to keep it alive. Here's Oates with the dig. Set by Cash for Oates into the net, and that's going to be 4 hits on Lincoln Memorial. Double hit, actually. And the Cobras will get it back as Kaylee Gunter comes back in. She's a 5'8 freshman from Johnsonville, South Carolina. Serves on its way. Snyder receives. Cash will set middle for Oates off the block, and response back there by the defenders in the back row. Here's Holland again off the angle into the block. Attacked by Gunter, blocked back by LMU. That one hit out off the end line, and LMU will capture set one, 25-18, to take a 1-0 lead in tonight's match with the Cobras. We'll take a timeout when we come back. Set two for tonight's match between Lincoln Memorial and Coker College. This is the Lincoln Memorial University Sports Network.
At Citizens Bank, we're different from everyone else. We've proudly served business communities of Northeast Tennessee since 1912 and have security you can count on. We offer the convenience of internet banking, excellent loan services on various types of loans, cash management, and small business banking at all of our convenient locations in Harrogate, Tazewell, New Tazewell, Bean Station, and Morristown. Visit our website to find out more at citizensbanktn.com. Citizens Bank, no more banking as usual.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
When it comes to insurance, former Railsplitter basketball player Brad Seal knows that a good offense can be a strong defense.
Are we on? Okay, we're back. Sorry about that, folks. We had a little confusion there as to whether we were on or not. And Mike and I thought we were, but then we were told we weren't, and then we were told we're back on. So, Mike, I don't know.
But you had a good discussion.
We did have a good discussion. You guys missed all the discussion about deer season coming in tomorrow in Tennessee for archery and soon to be in Virginia, and the former Railsplitter Mark Gilbert nailing a big one out in Western Kentucky. And you missed all of that. I know that you just couldn't live without that kind of information. So
Rusty with a nice little recap.
That's right. 1-0 here after the opening set. LMU winning at 25-18, Mike. And nice way to start here tonight. This team, you know, you'd never know by the way they played in the opening set that they're coming in here on a four-match losing streak.
No, they played with a lot of energy, a lot of enthusiasm. You know, they hit 209, held Coker to 053. I think the biggest thing, too, was they minimized their unforced errors.
Casey Mincy making the start here in the second set. One of the things that I noticed about Coker in the opening set is they really don't have that big presence on the outside hitters. They don't have that monstrous presence on the middle. They've got a pretty good defensive effort back there, but so far we've not seen that big offensive effort.
No, they like to spread the ball around, looks like, and, you know, the late rail splitters were attacking from pin to pin, really tried to take advantage of the middle and really, like I said, minimize their unforced errors.
All right, we're just about set to get underway. Mike, you had an update on a score from over Jefferson City a little while ago. I think you said Carson Newman took the opening set.
Carson Newman took the opening set, and Wingate was leading the second set.
That's going to be a battle.
Actually,
they
won the second set, so yeah, one set apiece.
One apiece. Nobody going down without a swing this year. Opening serve of set two. Mincy receives. Cash will set middle. Gill finds the far line. Again, just hung up there long enough to take a look at things and kept it in this area code over there and not out of the real estate. Whitaker serve short. Poor reception. Waters keeps it alive. Hit short and across. Fleeman digs it across, and that was just set up for the middle hitter right there, that being Alexis Burles. Now you just don't want to set him up like that.
No, you don't give yourself a whole lot of shot when that happens.
One all, Cobras with side out. Now, things were tight in the last set up until a certain point, and LMU was able to pull away late. Set to the far side. Holland really going up and elevating down line.
Give her four kills on the evening.
Good support here tonight, Mike. I see the LMU coaching, men's coaching staff over there. Softball team, of course, here. A lot of soccer. And golf,
lacrosse,
a lot of representation from the different sports. Waters across the grain, nice dig by Snyder. Joust at the net, Cash kept it alive. Holland hits it to the back row. Set to the middle, nice dig by LMU's Jazzy Oates. And that one hit way off the back line. Was that Mincy or Snyder?
Mincy. Yeah, definitely an unforced error right there.
I have to have a word with my down judge over here to stay out of my way. I couldn't see.
Have to have Mr. Ramsey move over.
That's right. That's right. Two all, high arcing serve. Snyder receives. Cash sets far side for Holland. Rejected back. Whitaker kept it alive. Here's Oates on the angle. And Karam's off of the block from Coker, and that'll give it back to LMU. Brock re-enters. Mincy goes out. Holland will go back to serve for the Lady Railsplitters. And I believe we saw a substitution for Coker as well. Here's the set by Bragg to the middle on the attack. That's Miller. And that went out off the far sideline.
Yeah, she tried to power that ball with a lower set.
LMU out to a 4-2 lead. Here's Holland again. Side out Lincoln Memorial. Floating serve off the back line. That one got away from her a bit. Substitution for LMU, Peyton McDaniel for the first time tonight. 5'4 and a sophomore to Morristown, Tennessee. Big high school football game going on over Morristown tonight between Morristown West and Knoxville Central.
Woo.
Both undefeateds, I think. Set to the far side. Brock, hard angle, runs out of room on the playing surface, and that'll be out back to Coker.
That was a severely sharp angle.
The ball floated a little bit on her, I believe. Four all served by Bragg. McDaniel receives. Set for Oates. Tipped across to the far side. Nice response by McDaniel. Here's Oates again off the angle. Blocked back at the net. And a poor swing that time by Miller, but it was enough to get the job done.
Yeah, when she cut it, It come right off the top of the net. Whitaker was there, and it hits the net, and she can't make the adjustment.
5-4. Cobras with the lead and side out. McDaniel receives again. Cash to Brock. Here's Brock again. Gets one to roll across the net for, set to the near side. The attack by Bingle. Cash to Snyder off the back row. Joust at the net again. Dug out of there by Miller. Oates and Brock with a block assist.
Yeah, nice timing by the LMU block. It was a higher set, so they had to be patient.
Tone Gill re-enters. That'll put Oates on serve, side out to Lincoln Memorial, and we're tied at 5. Set to the near side of the floor. Tipped across this time by Bragg. Set for Gill, and she it was tipped, Mike.
Off the top of the block.
I'm going to say she hit it off the back line, but it was touched. LMU back out by one. Set by Overholt. And I believe I missed the kill there, Mike.
I think it was
Bingle.
Number 8. Yeah, Bingle. I lost it as well.
Ties the set 6-all. Bingle will have serve side out to Coker. Floating serve. Whitaker receives. Brock. Nice swing on it. Just came down on it a little bit too quickly.
Yeah, she definitely pulled the attack down.
Mincy returns. Brock will go out of the lineup. 7-6. Cobras still with a one-point advantage. Short driving serve. Snyder digs it across. Whitaker was there to answer, but just couldn't keep it in play.
Yeah, Miller with the over attack.
Been a while since the Cobras led by 2, but it's 8-6 now as they maintain side out. Snyder receives. Cash sets for Gill. Gill, that swing again. I tell you what, Mike, she might be working on our player of the match if LMU comes out with a win here tonight.
Yeah, I think that's 6 kills on the night for her.
Her hitting percentage has got to be pretty strong. We don't have the stats in front of us tonight, but.
Well, she hit 429 in the first set.
Here's the set to the near side for Gunter. McDaniel with a dig. Cash will set for Fleeman, and that is rejected with authority by Shaylin Miller. There was another unidentified Coker player beside her, but Miller got all of them. Serve on its way by Waters. Kiara Holland returns for Lincoln Memorial. Side out to LMU, 8, serving 9. Mincy in there to serve. Set to the near side, the attack by Gunter. Cash puts it up there for Holland, and Holland has it sent back. Again, that was Burles and Bragg on the block assist.
And I think Bragg got most of that.
Hardy back in now for Coker. 10-8, Cobras with the advantage. Poor reception by Whitaker and a 3-point lead now. Jenny Michael looking with some concern out there. She tries to encourage her players to pick it up a bit.
Yeah, she's trying to let them play through it at this point.
Holland receives. Set for Gill. And again, it's going to be a Coker point, and Jenny Michael's going to call her timeout. 12-8, Cobras lead it. We'll take this break, and we'll be back. This is the LMU Sports Network.
When you're traveling throughout the tri-states, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express of Middlesboro. With nearly 60 rooms to choose from, fitness center, full complimentary hot breakfast bar, and seasonal pool, Holiday Inn Express of Middlesboro is all about catering to your travel needs. Our rooms are all equipped with flat-screen TV, refrigerator, microwave, and we're conveniently located just seconds from the area's attractions. When you're on the road, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express, located on the Cumberland Gap Parkway, Middlesboro. Make reservations today by calling 606-248-6860.
Welcome back. 12-8. Cobras lead it as we are in set 2. LMU won the opening set 25-18, but it has been a tight one here in set two. And so far in this match, the Cobras have not had as large a lead as they have in this particular set. 12-8 is the largest it's been. The serve will be with Coker. Kristen Bragg will step back there to do the honors. Serves on its way. Whitaker receives. Cash sets middle. Gill rejected. Dug across by Fleeman. Now here's Gunter, and a double hit called on Coker. Like I said, Mike, we'll take all the luck we get.
Yeah, a little delay on that call that time. Quite a bit of hand movement there.
Set to the middle, tipped across this time by Burles. Here's Fleeman. Had a little angle on it, but she had a good downswing as well.
Yeah, Gunter gave her a little bit more of the line than she should have, and she buzzed it right by her.
10 serving, 12. Whitaker with a jump serve. Dump. And unfortunately, LMU couldn't respond quickly enough. They had a lot of people converge on that ball, but very close to going to a four hit right there.
Yeah, there was a lot of movement and quick reaction with that.
Cobras survive, at least for the time. They lead it by three. Served by Reed. Cash back set for Fleeman. And that one was blocked at the net, but it stayed on the Coker side, and LMU will get credit for that point as Fleeman got the kill.
Yeah, Fleeman really, you know, left sides really have to work hard against her. She's got a strong attack.
LMU trying to even this thing up again here. They're 2 points down. Mincy, cash again with a dump right at Reed. Holland responds on the dig, set to the middle. Oates trying to go to the back line and gets it in there. I think she caught Bragg just enough off balance that time that she couldn't really get a whole lot on it.
Yeah, she's got the defense moving when she's attacking like that.
Set to the near sideline for Bingle, and Bingle hits the net with it. That'll again stay with Lincoln Memorial, and just like that, Mike, we're right back into the set here, 13 all.
Oh, yeah, when you're, you know, they're minimizing the errors again.
Set for Bingle. Across the grain, Mincy answers. Cash sets far side for Holland. Holland on the downswing.
Yeah, that when Holland is hot.
Timeout. LMU has come roaring back from four down to take a one-point lead. 14-13, Lady Railsplitters. This is LMU Volleyball on the LMU Sports Network.
Make K&K Metal Sales your only stop for all your residential and commercial metal building needs. For the past 23 years, K&K Metal Sales has covered the tri-state area with quality custom roofing and siding with many grades, gauges, and colors in stock. If you're looking for complete steel or wood building packages or steel or wood trusses, K&K Metal Sales can help with that, as well as heavy-duty custom carports. Great folks and great prices. Stop by K&K Metal Sales located at 6986 Cumberland Gap Parkway or call 423-869-426.
Mike, I want to point something out. Our judge on the podium today, you can't really see him that well in the shot, Modi Benami, actually had a daughter that was on one of the American Idols.
American Idol.
Mm-hmm. And she really went a long way in that contest.
I think she went into the final 10.
Just goes to show you, it can happen. We know a couple around this area from over in Bell County, Kentucky, that made it to the final two or three, I think one of them did. Set to the far side for Hardy, and that'll fall in for the – actually, it'll be tipped.
I think that come off Whitaker's head.
It may have. She's got a kind of a smile on her face about it. Ties the set at 14-all. Serve to the far side. Mincy receives. Cash will set for Holland. Holland keeps it in on the near corner. She used everything she had on the real estate there.
Oh, yeah, a lot of top spin.
Brock returns. Holland will step back there to serve. That'll send Mincy out of the lineup. Also, Burles, goes out of the lineup for Coker. Set to the middle. Actually, the far side, and that was Hardy. Tell you what, Shaylin Miller went up right there and fooled me. I thought she was going to swing it on it. Hardy goes out. Returning for the Cobras is Kara Overholt. We're tied at 15. Set two on the night. Short serve, Whitaker to Cash, to Brock. And the block comes into effect for Coker.
Yeah,
we're going to call it four hits.
Yeah, Brock really trying to get on track here.
Tie ball at the net. Oates trying to come to the near sideline and does, as she gets credit for the kill. And Lincoln Memorial ties it up at 16.
She did a great job that time, not overhitting, turning the angle, seeing the open spot of the court, and just pulling it off the hands.
Serve to the middle of the floor. Set to the far side. That was Bingle on the attack. Here's Brock. Brock off of two defenders. And LMU trying to take that advantage here into what would be a second win if they can capture set two. 17-16, Oates to the far side. I tell you what, it doesn't even look like Shaylin Miller leaves the floor when she swings on it. She's got a very odd release.
Yeah, she's got a high ball contact, and just right there, Snyder comes busting in and just gets right on top of her.
17 all, side out to Coker. Set for Brock and splits the double team back there on the back line.
Yeah, they ran a little combo action that time. Brock able to put it away off the hands.
Fleeman returns, Snyder out of the lineup. That'll put Cash on serve, side out to LMU. 18-17. That one looked like a very bad reception, and LMU just didn't respond to it. Doug, all the way across the neck, Mike. That's the kind of thing you can't have happen.
Yeah, you hope a blocker's up to take care of that.
Short serve. Brock receives. Whitaker has to hustle to get to it. And Gill gets it across. Set to the middle. There's Tone Gill at the net. All by her lonesome.
Yeah, Gill did a nice job of taking the hitter one-on-one.
Mincy back in there as Brock comes out. Also, Holland returns, 19-18. It's getting down to crunch time here on this set as Mincy will go to serve. To the back line. Set to the far side, tipped across. Nice response by Whitaker, but she got it across on the dig, and the kill was executed by Gunter.
Yeah, Coach Michael wanting a net call there, but I believe it was more ball than it was anything.
Hardy back in there for Coker as Overholt comes out. That puts Bragg back on the service line. 19 all. Things staying very close here in the second set of the night. Whitaker receives. Cash sets middle. Punched across by Gill. Set backside for Hardy. Fleeman blocked back. And again, that front line really caused LMU some problems. That was Burles that went up and got most of it. But yeah, block assist there as well. Sorry.
Yeah, they keyed on Fleeman that time.
Cobras with a 1-point advantage in this set. Fleeman blocked back, and I believe, did Holland make contact or did it fall in?
It fell in.
Timeout Lincoln Memorial. They trail 21-19. We're back after this with more on the LMU Sports Network. Afternoon, 2 o'clock start here at the Mary E. Mars Gymnasium. We'll have pregame coverage at 1:50. LMU versus Wingate University. Wingate in a fight of their own over in Jefferson City tonight. At last we heard it was tied a set apiece. Carson Newman taking the opening stanza. Wingate came back to tie it up. And set three probably still going on as we speak. Rusty Peace, Mike Smith here with you tonight for Lady Railsplitter Volleyball. And right now, Coker trying to even things up here as they've got a 2-point lead in set two. This is Bragg on the serve. Set middle for Gill, punches it to the middle. And another kill for that young lady, Mike. I'll tell you, she's having a night.
She's working things out. Like I said, right there, she didn't have to attack it too hard. She just found the open area.
Technically still considered a freshman as she redshirted a year ago due to an injury. There's Cash setting far side for Holland, blocked back. Whitaker keeps it alive. Here's Fleeman from the near side. That one off the hands of Bragg and kept alive by the Cobras, but hit out of play on that desperation effort to get it across the net. We are tied at 21. Minimizing the errors, Mike. You said that a minute ago. That might be the key phrase of the night.
Oh, absolutely.
Short serve. Nice serve by Whitaker. Dumped across. Cash comes up with it. Fleeman got to take a little something off that. They're starting to read her too easy. She's powering it in there, and they're reading it.
Yeah, that ball may have actually been out of bounds.
22-21. Cobras back out by one. Short serve crawls across the tape. Set to the middle for Oates on the downswing. Oates again stays in play right on the line.
Changed angles, changed sides. Really found the open spot. Nice job, Jazzy Oates.
Bristol Snyder returns side out with Lincoln Memorial as we're tied at 22. This is where you can't afford errors, unforced errors in particular. Across the grain, set for Holland. Off the block, point Lincoln Memorial. LMU got the point, but a nice effort by Coker's Missy Reed to try to keep that one in play on the layout dive to the near sideline.
Yeah, Reed saw that one playing out.
Service error by Snyder, and that'll tie us up again at 23.
Critical unforced error that time.
Alexis Burrell serving for Coker. Tight ball at the net. Joust won by Coker. And again, that was big Shaylin Miller, 6'1 sophomore out of Campton Hills, Illinois.
She's got a long reach.
Set point now for Coker as they try to even it up. Mincy to Cash for Holland. Holland on the downswing.
No answer.
Well, I'll tell you what, she and Gill are having a night here and really providing some offense from the middle and that far side.
Yeah, she pounded that ball.
24 all, LMU looking for the advantage here as Holland goes back to serve. Long serve, back line again. Mike just giving it to him. Unforced errors.
Yeah, that's costly.
Re-entering now for Coker, Kara Overholt, as that sends Megan Hardy out of the lineup. And again, that would make it set point for the Cobras. Poor reception by Snyder. Set for Brock. Tipped back, dug up. Hit across by Cash. Kept alive. Good night. Nice response by Whitaker. Set for Oates on the angle. Out of play. And the Cobras capture set two, 26-24 to even this match at a set apiece. What do you know? All right, we're going to a third set. That'll be about 3 minutes from now. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back. This is the Lincoln Memorial University Sports Network. I'm good, thanks.
It's the Old Town Grill.
The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family, more than friends. Bring a hearty appetite, because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
Whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Subway of Harrogate and Middlesbrough has your fresh interest at heart. On your way to work, try one of our mouth-watering breakfast sandwiches or flatbread omelets. If it's lunch or dinner you're after, choose from a wide selection of classic, select, or premium sandwiches that are all made specifically to order. Serving a crowd, Subway also has sandwich platters, giant subs, box lunches, and even cookie platters. Be it dine in or carry out, you can eat healthy and eat fresh at Subway. 368 Catawba Avenue in Harrogate and on the corner of the Village Square Mall, Middlesbrough.
Whether institutional case good or architectural woodwork, Nolan Products Incorporated of Knoxville has been serving East Tennessee, Southwest Virginia, and Southeast Kentucky since 1958. From concept to finish, Nolan Products custom builds to the highest quality standards to meet your facility specifications while using only the finest materials available. Nolan Products has been serving and meeting the needs and requirements of general contractors and architects in East Tennessee and surrounding area for more than 55 years. Nolan Products Incorporated, 912 Forsyth Street, Northeast, Knoxville.
Pinnacle Performance Physical Therapy wants you to know you have a choice where to receive physical and occupational therapy. We take an individualized approach to treating people of all ages. Our therapist's goal is to assist all patients by reaching their pinnacle performance in school, work, and play. We have state-of-the-art equipment such as our AlterG anti-gravity treadmill, used to rehabilitate injuries and pain throughout the body's lower extremities. Contact us for an appointment at 423-869-9923. Pinnacle Performance Physical Therapy, 362 Catalpa Avenue, Harrogate.
The quarter pounder with cheese. A juicy, simply seasoned patty seared to perfection. Having one next to you can be a little distracting. In fact, it's so beefy and cheesy that... wait a minute. What was I just saying?
Now at McDonald's, get two classic quarter pounders with cheese for only $4. Two great sandwiches for a price you'll be loving.
It's the Old Town Grill.
The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family, more than friends. Bring a hearty appetite. Because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
The OTG, it's the place to be. Should the Lady Railsplitters go on to win tonight, we'll be selecting an Old Town Grill University Medical Clinic player of the match. And right now, things are all tied up one apiece as Coker came back to win set two, 26-24. Mike, that one went right down to the wire and then some.
Yeah, that unfortunately unforced errors came back to cost the Lady Railsplitters.
Opening serve of set three. Set to the far side, and nice dig there by Whitaker. Kleeman right off the block, and LMU will start out with the opening point.
Nice set by Abby Cash that time. Erica Whitaker make a really nice dig.
Cash has been such a vital part of this team since coming here several years ago. That one hit out off the far sideline by, I believe, Bragg. Bragg sets up there and right into the block as the kill will go to Burles and Coker as it's now 2-1 Lincoln Memorial side out with the Cobras.
Yeah, Burles just powered that ball through Fleeman and Gill. Looked like Fleeman was just a little late.
Whitaker to Cash to Gill and just a hitting error on Gill's part. Hit that one right into the tape.
Yeah, Gill had 9 kills in the first two sets. Was hitting 467 till that error.
Tied again at 2. Set near side for Mincy. Hit across this time by Bragg.
Nice pickup by Holland.
Long volley here. Hit out off the far sideline by Hardy. Mike, you know, you guys call it a rally, and I've always heard it as a volley back a long time ago.
Yeah. Different terminology over time.
From the decades. You called it a tip, and it used to be called a dink.
Yep. Sometimes they call a dig a bump.
There's a nice block assist by Gill and Holland. As the two paired up right there to come up with a denial. 4-2 Lincoln Memorial side out with the Lady Railsplitters. Reception back there by Reed. Set to the far side on the attack. It's Bingle. Here's Bingle again. Blocked again. That's Gill and Fleeman.
Yeah, Gill just planted over top of the net that time. There was no prayer on that one.
Tone Gill, you know, we heard a lot of things about her a year ago, what help she would provide, and she's really showing that tonight. Gill and Fleeman again, Mike. They made me look like I knew what I was talking about.
They're trying to turn it into a block party on that side.
Timeout, Coker, 6-2. Lady Railsplitters, we're back after this with more on the LMU Sports Network.
Pinnacle Performance Physical Therapy wants you to know you have a choice where to receive physical and occupational therapy. We take an individualized approach to treating people of all ages. Our therapist's goal is to assist all patients by reaching their pinnacle performance in school, work, and play. We have state-of-the-art equipment such as our Alter-G anti-gravity treadmill, used to rehabilitate injuries and pain throughout the body's lower extremities. Contact us for an appointment at 423-869-9923. Pinnacle Performance Physical Therapy, 362 Catalpa Avenue,
Welcome back. Rusty Peace, Mike Smith here with you tonight. Mike, you just gave us an update on that score from over in Jefferson City.
23-21 Wingate in the third set.
Going down to the wire, Shelton Collier feeling a little bit of pressure for some teams throughout the SAC this year.
Yeah, I think you're gonna look into a competitive race throughout the year. If you look at the standings right now, there's some good volleyball going on in the South Atlantic Conference.
Now, the record he has had since taking over the volleyball program at Wingate has just been phenomenal.
Yeah, he's, you know, year in and year out, he puts a quality squad out, and they compete from the first serve to the last serve.
When was the last time that someone other than Wingate won the regular season and conference tournament title? There's a trivia question for you. It's been a long time.
It's been a while.
LMU with a serving error that time, and that'll give side out to the Cobras. Launch that one off the back line. Jump serve on its way. Short serve. Whitaker lays out to respond. Here's Holland, and she is rejected back. LMU getting a little of their own medicine right there, as that appeared to be Miller and Hardy on the block assist.
Yeah, it was a little slower tempo play. It allowed Coker's block time to get out to the pin.
Jump serve to the back row. Whitaker to Cash, now over to Fleeman, off the block, kept alive, and put into play nicely by Miller, who located right to the center of the LMU defense.
I think that's six kills on the night for Miller. She's had a good night in the middle for Coker.
She's got a really odd attack, Mike. She just doesn't elevate at all, doesn't seem like. Fleeman trying to hit it across, right into the block again. That one off the back of Casey Mincy.
Mincy went into cover, and when she went to cover, she couldn't get out of the way.
Now the lead has diminished and actually completely dissipated as we're tied at six. That one just off the back line. Very close, Mike. One of those.
Just off.
Another fraction of an inch that could have easily been called in. 7-6, side out Lincoln Memorial. Whitaker on serve. Set to the near side. The attack by Hardy. Blocked back, kept in play. But up there by Waters.
She tooled it off the block, tooled it off Holland.
Overholt returns now for Coker. 7-7. Set 3. We hoped this one would go 3. We haven't seen any this year that have gone 3.
Nice cover by Whitaker.
Both teams struggling a little bit with passing. And LMU with a kill right there despite the layout dig effort by Overholt.
Yeah, Oates changed her angle that time. She got denied, I think, the first time through and changed her shoulder angle and was able to tool it off the block.
I think that particular exchange, both coaches probably felt like the passing was less than desirable. Cash with a dump. Didn't catch anybody off guard. Holland finds the seam.
If the block is not set, Kiera really powers through it.
She has really been a factor from that outside hitter position tonight on the angle, not down line as she was in the last match we called. Hit over by Reed. Oates to the back corner and out of play.
Yeah, didn't follow through on that attack, and so she kind of knuckleballed it.
9-8, LMU still holding a one-point advantage, but side out to the Cobras. Cash for Holland, off the block, kept alive there by Overholt. Hit across, this time by Bragg. Holland again, has it blocked back.
Long rally.
A long exchange here. Oates trying to shut the door. And it will go to Coker as Kaylee Gunter caromed off one of the hands of the defenders at the net.
Yeah, I believe it went right off the inside arm of Abby Cash.
Ties the set at 9. Side out with Coker. Snyder, hard ball at the net, tipped across by Cash. And a flicker of the lights there. Mike, I thought
that's not good.
I don't think it's supposed to storm tonight. Gunter on the attack. Cash sets middle. McKinnon battling up there along with Cash. And they're going to rule that that is actually a lift on Lincoln Memorial. It had to be either on McKinnon or Cash.
I think they're going to get an overrule here. I think they're going to get a net call here.
Four hits called on Coker, and I think that might have been what the players were pointing there at the net. I think that's what they were talking about.
Yeah, I think Coach Rafalowski's wanting to know if the four hits occurred before the net call happened.
Now, there's a deep conversation taking place between the down judge and Coach Rafalowski.
Yeah, I think that's the discussion that's going to be had right here. Did the four attacks happen before?
There you see the discussion taking place over at the podium. Marty Benami, the up judge, and then on the floor that is it Gary? Last name?
Ramsey.
Ramsey, Gary Ramsey. Don't know why I was wanting to say Gary Durbin. Well, apparently the call is justified. Brock will re-enter. LMU on top 10-9, and they'll gain side out with the exchange. Here's Holland. Set to the middle, and nobody was there. Lack of communication there.
Yeah, Overholt thought that Miller was coming that way.
Yeah, I think Gunter thought it was going to be set for her as well, mm-hmm. And she made a run at it, but it wasn't anywhere close. And then Holland will give it back on the service error. It just happens. You hate to see it, but
you're not trying to do it on purpose.
That's right. Snyder to Cash to McKinnon, Point Lincoln Memorial. McKinnon hadn't been in much tonight. That's the first one she's had in her wheelhouse, and she was set perfectly right there. 2-point advantage for the Lady Railsplitters, 12-10. Set up there by Overholt, hit across, Snyder responds. Brock will get it back over there for Lincoln Memorial. There's Brock and Gill. She just is involved in everything tonight, Mike.
Yeah, she's all over the – she's going pin to pin and really taking up a lot of space.
Tone Gill working on some numbers here tonight, 13-10 Lincoln Memorial. Tight ball at the net again. And a double called on the set. Unlucky break for the Cobras, and you don't want to let this thing get away from you too much here in this set because you may not be able to recover.
Yeah, you definitely feel the momentum swinging.
McKinnon on serve, diving ball off the table. Here's the attack from Bragg. Set for Brock across a tough angle, tipped out of play, Point Lincoln Memorial.
Lady Railsplitters are on a roll right now.
Timeout, Cobras, 15-10, Lincoln Memorial. This is LMU Volleyball on the Lincoln Memorial University Sports Network.
Hey, did you order the brownie?
A little extra to keep your mouth shut.
Kids, Grandma's famous brownies.
Homemade flavor delivered. Get our genuine Hershey's triple chocolate brownie just $5.99, only at Pizza Hut.
This football season, we get anything we want. Any toppings, any specialty, any large Pizza Hut pizza for just $10.
If only this could last forever.
But it won't. Now until September 27th, bring on the flavor with a $10 any carryout deal. Only at Pizza Hut.
Welcome back. Barry Mars Gymnasium hopping with excitement tonight. Good student support, good fan support on this Friday night matchup. And, Mike, it's unfortunate we have multiple sporting events going on at the same time because tomorrow soccer team's on the road. You got, a practice from some other teams. I think baseball's actually out on the field right now. Or they were when we came out. Looks like the lights may be out there right now. We must be raining outside again. Down line, a service ace for Allison McKinnon. Wow. Jenny Michael just turned to the bench and said happy birthday or something like that. I don't know. 16-10 Lincoln Memorial. And then gave it away off the back line. Got a little bit too carried away with that one.
Yeah, Kenny was definitely aggressive with the serve.
Kristen Bragg on serve for Coker. Reception by Snyder, set to the middle for Gill. Another kill. You know, Mike, talking about that miscue on the serve right after that service ace a minute ago, there was a former LMU coach, I'm not going to mention any names, but he made a statement to me one time that is probably one of the most profound statements in athletics that I've heard, and he was not that successful of a coach at Lincoln Memorial. But let's finish this one. Brock with the attack. His statement was, you'll never be the golfer you could be because you have the inability to forget your last shot. And that is such a great piece of advice to anybody in athletics. When you make a bad shot, you've got to forget it. When you make a good shot, you got to forget it. You got to move to the next one.
Yeah, you got to go on the next play.
Brock to the back corner.
They just keep covering and just stay after it.
Listen to that crowd, Mike. They are into this one. And that is just such a huge factor when you get that crowd behind you.
Absolutely.
You can feel the momentum roll. You're up 18-11 now. You want to just keep rolling here. Set to the far side. The block assist, guess who? Tone Gill and Brooke Fleeman. They've teamed up at least three times tonight.
Yeah, they're definitely shutting that left side down.
Short serve. Set, far side, the attack by Hardy. Hit across by the Cobras. Here's Cash, Brock on the attack. Back set again for Hardy. That one out off the far sideline, point to Lincoln Memorial.
Yeah, Abby Cash doing a nice job holding her line on the right side.
Jenny Michael's got to be pleased with what she's seen here in about the last 8 or 10 points.
Yeah, good gritty effort.
Tipped across. Nice effort by Whitaker that came from the back row. And Jenny Michael out there to kind of kick her in the hiney a little bit. Maybe she was a little late getting there.
She wants her to go with her left arm.
Gotcha. Gotcha.
She dove right arm instead of the left arm, which would have been easier.
In fact, I think she got onto her the last match about the same thing.
I believe you are correct.
It's hard to break tendencies sometimes. Brock. Oh, my goodness. Right in the wheelhouse.
Up in elevation, right over the top.
21-12, Lady Railsplitters on a roll here in set three. Trying to snap a four-match win streak, or lose streak. And a serving miscue off the back line by Mincy. Thing I like about being at the volleyball match, there's never any question when the men's basketball team walks in because you see all these big tall bodies coming in. Fleeman to the back line. And again, the Lady Rails put her stay on the roll.
Yeah, she's starting to get cranked up tonight.
McKinnon returns for LMU. Waters back in for Coker. Nice serve by Whitaker. And it'll be an ace.
That ball had a lot of drop on it.
Looked like a knuckleball, too. It just kind of floated and then fell when it crossed the net.
Yeah, she leads the Lady Railsplitters in aces. I think that's 14 on the year.
23-13. Block assist, Holland and McKinnon. How big a factor has the net been tonight for LMU?
Yeah, anytime you can block to win points, that's big. Really big.
Substitution now for the Cobras. Olivia, I think that's Vith. 5'10 freshman out of Pensacola, Florida, at outside hitter. There's that odd swing again by Miller that is so effective.
Yeah, she's been a lot of the offense for the Cobras tonight.
Re-entering for Coker, Kara Overholt. She'll be back there to serve. Set point for the Lady Railsplitters, 24-14. Down line, Holland receives. Here's Cash setting to McKinnon. And the win here in set three on that kill. 25-14 is how it goes in the books. Lady Railsplitters are up 2-1 as we go to set four. Will it be the last? We don't know. We'll have to wait and see. This is the LMU Sports Network.
From sales to service, online or in person, Anchor Marine of Speedwell, Tennessee is the source for all your boating needs. We carry a wide selection of new and used products and services for Alumacraft, Aqua Patio, Hurricane, Party Craft, Polar Craft, Rinker, Sandpan, and Sweetwater Boats and Pontoons, as well as a full line of Yamaha Marine Engines and Minn Kota Trolling Motors. From bow to stern, Anchor Marine also carries a wide selection of boating accessories. And if it's service you need, we offer on-site factory-trained technicians that are among the best in East Tennessee. Anchor Marine, 6630 General C.W. Steiner Highway, Speedwell.
At Citizens Bank, we're different from everyone else. We've proudly served business communities of Northeast Tennessee since 1912 and have security you can count on. We offer the convenience of internet banking, excellent loan services on various types of loans, cash management, and small business banking at all of our convenient locations in Harrogate, Tazewell, New Tazewell, Bean Station, and Morristown. Visit our website to find out more at citizensbanktn.com. Citizens Bank, no more banking as usual.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Established in 1982, Dixie Roofing Incorporated of La Follette has been the industry's leader in commercial roofing throughout Knoxville, Tennessee and surrounding counties for more than 30 years. From medical facilities to office buildings and educational institutions, Dixie Roofing has the experience, expertise, equipment, and know-how to handle roofing needs of any commercial structure, big or small. Dixie Roofing is also on the web at www.dixieroofing.com. Dixie Roofing Incorporated.
When it comes to insurance, former Railsplitter basketball player Brad Seal knows that a good offense can be a strong defense. When you and your family need auto coverage, home, or life insurance, Farm Bureau considers it an honor to have the opportunity to earn your business while at the same time giving you and your family coverage you can count on. Call us today at 869-8346 or stop by our Harrogate location at 932 Patterson Road and find out why Tennessee turns to us for insurance. Experience our exceptional service at Farm Bureau.
When you're traveling throughout the tri-states, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express of Middlesboro. With nearly 60 rooms to choose from, fitness center, full complimentary hot breakfast bar, and seasonal pool, Holiday Inn Express of Middlesboro is all about catering to your travel needs. Our rooms are all equipped with flat-screen TV, refrigerator, microwave, and we're conveniently located just seconds from the area's attractions. When you're on the road, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express, located on the Cumberland Gap Parkway, Middlesboro. Make reservations today by calling 606-248-6860.
Juggling my family's schedule is a full-time job. Between school, dance practice, work, there's little time left to worry about much else. That's why I use real-time banking from Home Federal Bank. With real-time banking, I know that when I make a deposit, the money goes straight to my account. No delays, no waiting, no wondering. And I get to focus on what's important.
Real-time deposits, real-time access, real-time banking from Home Federal Bank. Always within reach.
Catherine Lundy, goalkeeper for the Lady Railsplitter soccer team, with us on the air momentarily. Tomorrow afternoon they'll be in action. Catherine, this defense being quite stingy, we're not allowing a lot of goals, but we got to figure out a way to get more wins, and we got ties right now. What's up with this tie thing?
I don't know. It's a real problem right now, to be honest. We've never had this many ties in my whole 3 years here, so I hope we can get some wins going on.
Big
now.
Match tomorrow, and it's a tough place to play. What do you expect in that one?
I'm hoping that we win. I mean, well, if we come out strong, I think we'll get it. Last year we beat them 1-0 and at home, but I hope we can beat them by more tomorrow at their place.
Well, Catherine will be in the net tomorrow. We want to wish you the best of luck. Good luck to the team tomorrow.
Thanks.
All right, Lady Railsplitters in action against Lenore Ryan on the road today, or tomorrow rather, over in Hickory, North Carolina. And you can catch that match progressing more than likely online through the LMU Athletics website or, of course, through the Lenore Ryan University website tomorrow afternoon. All right, we're set to get underway here in set four. Rusty Peace, Mike Smith here with you as the opening serve will come from Coker. Holland really had the dig and just absolutely set up Kaylee Gunter for the opening point of the set.
Yeah, not the way you want to come out here in set four.
A 1-0 Coker. They're going to try to even things up. That's what they have to do if this match will continue. Oh, my goodness. Holland on the downswing, this time down line.
Yeah, you see Vyth out there going, I've got to get to the pin. Yeah.
Yeah, you do that. Not going to help you any because that one's going in the book. 1-1. Attack this time from, I think that's Ariane Jewell. She's a 5'10 middle hitter freshman out of Canton, Georgia. Her first action of the match. So, Coach Rafalowski kind of mixing things up a little bit on this particular set. 3-1 Lincoln Memorial. Three straight points reeled off here, Mike, after giving up that first point.
Yeah, they're starting to show a little more momentum.
Whitaker goes back row with it. Set far side over to Gunter. Whitaker to Fleeman. Set up there for McKinnon. Location kill. As she changed direction very quickly and just saw an open zone.
Kenny, I think, is 4-for-4 attacking right now.
Lincoln Memorial on a four-point run here. 4-1 now, Lady Railsplitters. Nice response by Whitaker on that dig. Gunter blocked back. And that'll be four hits. I think that was Fleeman and McKinnon. And, you know, those two love to get up on the net together.
It's really – LMU's blocking has really come around. In set three, they had six team blocks.
Tough ball right there. And Holland goes to receive in a receiving error on that dig.
Everybody came to her and – she dug it right into McKinnon, I believe.
Well, you knew it had to come to an end sooner or later. Five straight points that time by Lincoln Memorial. It's 5-2, side out to the Cobras.
Good response opening up after giving up the first point.
Set for Holland. Again, off the block. No, it's going to be off the antenna. And that'll go back to Coker. Some of the women's basketball team coming in support tonight. Holland. To Cash, back set for Fleeman. Down line. Nice job by a hustle that time by Bragg to get to it.
Bragg doesn't let it fall.
Fleeman again into the block. Tipped across. Coker bench wanting a tip there. And it doesn't matter as the truth prevails with, I think that's Veith or Veith. Getting the kill. I hate it when I don't know the proper pronunciation.
Yeah, they just stayed after it. You gotta give them credit for staying after it right there.
Now three straight points by the Cobras. And another discussion going on over at the podium between the judge on stand, the official on stand, and the linesman. Any idea what that's about?
No, I think they were just talking about the contact on the hands there. Now the linesman fixing the antenna.
Earning their money tonight. 5-4. Side out staying with the Cobras. Set for McKinnon. Another nice swing by.
That was a bullet.
McKinnon that time. Here's a nice one by Hammond. Nice response again by Whitaker. Tight ball in the net, hit across by the Cobras. Fleeman into the block. Again, there's Whitaker to respond. Holland telegraphs that one out of play. And like LMU reeled off five straight, Coker has reeled off four straight.
Yeah, that was good coverage by both teams right there. Holland just unfortunately a little late on the swing.
Arcing serve at Holland. Set middle for McKinnon off the block and out of play. That'll be point to Lincoln Memorial, and LMU will finally get side out before being broken. They managed to tie it up, but they weren't able to break the Lady Railsplitters right there. There's the block assist again by a couple of, actually won't go into book as such, but nice effort defensively. Holland battling at the net. Set far side on the attack. It is Veith. And that'll be out of play to Lincoln Memorial.
A lot of long rallies going here.
Well, Coker right now is fighting for their life. They've got to have a win in this set if they're to keep this alive.
Nice up by Mincy.
Good-looking kill that time from Madison Bingle.
Give Coker credit. They're staying active. They're fighting.
And they're going to be facing a beast tomorrow when they go over to Jefferson City as well. Get an update on that score shortly. 7-6, side out to Coker. Served by Burles. LMU not receiving that one too well. Set near side, here's Bingle again on the attack. Holland down line and in play. I love the way she switched this up, Mike. She was going across the grain, now she's going down line.
Yeah, she made a nice adjustment that time.
Several individuals we could probably look at for player of the match tonight should LMU go on to win it. A little bit early to be talking about that. There's Brock and McKinnon again at the net. I'm not sure that they got contact with that, but they'll be credited with a block assist. LMU back out to a 9-6 lead. Holland still holding side out. Set near side on the attack. It's Bingle. Tight ball at the net. The joust won by Coker. Brock on the swing. McKinnon again. She has come out of nowhere, Mike.
She is just, you know, sometimes she's a spark plug.
What was her last hitting percentage for the match?
Perfect. I don't know what it is now, but it was perfect earlier.
There's McKinnon and Brock at the net. Bingle across the grain. Whitaker answers. Set for McKinnon. Brock into the block. Hit across by McKinnon. There's that swing again from Shaylin Miller. And I'll tell you what, it's the oddest thing that I've ever seen. She gets this huge arm swing motion, but no elevation.
Yeah, it's a tough swing to defend. And she's been very good with it tonight.
10-7. Side out to the Cobras. Set for Brock. Walks down the net right into the hands of the official, and that's going to be out of play.
Yeah, at times the net's been good to us, and at times the net's been bad to us.
Well, what's the call here? They put the score wrong on the scoreboard. I didn't see a tip on that, Mike.
Not sure who made the call here.
Well, the score was put up 11-7 both on our monitor and on the board. And the way it looked, that should have been Coker Point. But the serve is going to be awarded to Lincoln Memorial. I don't know exactly what just took place there.
He called a touch on the middle somehow.
He walked right down the tape. I never saw it touched anywhere. And a receiving error called on Coker's Madison Bingle. And a timeout now to the Cobras. 12-7, Lady Railsplitters by 5 here in set 4. Back after this on the LMU Sports Network.
Known for his purpose, his determination, and his ability to see a path laid before him and step into it with utmost certainty. At Lincoln Memorial University, we recognize those who do the same. The few who, in the face of adversity, choose destiny over indifference. Like Lincoln, they stand apart. And here is where they hang their hat. Lincoln Memorial University. Your career path is here.
Back once again, Rusty Peace, Mike Smith here with you. Set 4. And Mike, the Lady Railsplitters out to a 5-point lead, trying to close the door in 4. And you can look down through the results from the year. I'm telling you, they've had one 3-0 match, and that was down there in Savannah, Georgia against Erskine that they won. The rest of them have gone at least 4.
Yeah, they've extended a lot of matches, and give them credit here in set 4. They come out, they lost the first point, they made a big run, gave up a couple points, and now they made another run again.
Allison McKinnon on serve for Lincoln Memorial. Serve dives off the table in the back row. Tipped across. Brock with the swing. There's Bengal. And Snyder gets it across. Well, she did get a little elevation on that one. Shayla Miller came off the floor, and that one really showed because it had a lot on it.
Yeah, Miller, I'm not sure what her hitting percentage is, but she's having a big night.
Poor reception by Snyder, and now it's Coker on the comeback trail. Snyder receives, Cash sets for Brock. Down line, back corner, point LMU.
She found the opening. Sometimes you don't have to hit it that hard. You just got to find the spot.
Brooke Fleeman back in the lineup. Snyder comes out. That'll send Cash back to serve. 13-9, Lady Railsplitters trying to open it up a little bit more. Set to the near side for Gunter. Hit across by Holland at the net, and what a swing Kristen Bragg took on that ball.
Yeah, she saw that overpass and eyes got big.
Live for that in the backyard, Mike. Pull the net down and hit it across. Whitaker, poor reception. Holland bails her out, hit across by Fleeman. Tight ball at the net. And a point again for the Cobras as Gunter is credited with a kill. Timeout, Lincoln Memorial. And we've got a two-point set with LMU on top, 13-11. Back after this on the LMU Sports Network.
The quarter pounder with cheese. A juicy, simply seasoned patty seared to perfection. Having one next to you can be a little distracting. In fact, it's so beefy and cheesy that... wait a minute. What was I just saying?
Now at McDonald's, get two classic quarter pounders with cheese for only $4. Two great sandwiches for a price you'll be loving.
We think we have an unconfirmed final score from Jefferson City, Tennessee. Mike?
3-1 Wingate, I believe, wins it.
You know, really no surprise there. It's what you've grown to expect over the years of volleyball that Shelton Collier has put on the floor over in Wingate, North Carolina. But again, that is unconfirmed. Fleeman across the grain. Nice dump that time by the setter. That is Bragg, who went the other way with it.
Like a reverse layup.
That's exactly right.
A couple other finals as well. Queens beats Mars Hill 3-0, and Lenore Ryan beats Newberry 3-1.
13-12. Holland to Whitaker, far side for Brock. Brock gets a little help from the tape. Cash sets for Brock. Gill into the net, point Coker. You know, Mike, I was about to say that before that miscue right there. It seems like LMU has gone away here in the last couple of sets from setting Gill in the middle. Why is that?
I think sometimes it's ball control, and then sometimes it's going to the hot hitter.
I didn't know if possibly there was something defensively. There's a nice swing by Fleeman. If there was something defensively that Coker was doing that really took him out of that.
Well, I think part of it starts when the long rallies are making digs on both sides of the net, and sometimes when those longer rallies happen, you get away from sometimes the things that go best for you.
14-13, the swing that time by Gunter into the tape. Four hits called, and that'll be side out again to Lincoln Memorial. Desperation hit across the net that time by the Cobras. Here's Holland. Oh, my goodness.
One-on-one, she's just going to make you pay.
Bring it in with authority, Miss Holland. Nice swing that time on the attack.
That was Bragg.
By Bragg. And that'll get Veith back off the bench and into the lineup for Coker as Bragg steps back there to serve. 16-14, LMU. Diving serve, Whitaker handles. Here's Fleeman across the grain, right into Bragg's hands. Hit across by Veith. Set for Holland, and again, almost the same spot. That one could do nothing more than go vertical.
Yeah, the quickness that time of Holland, the middles just can't close that quick to the pin.
Nice set for the middle, Alexis Burles right there on that exchange. That'll get Reed back into the lineup for Coker. 17-15, side out to the Cobras again. Cash sets for McKinnon. It'd been a while, we knew it, but you knew when she gets in that wheelhouse right there, it's going
to
go.
Absolutely. The middles are cheating to the pins right now, and McKinnon made them pay.
That'll put Bristol Snyder back there to serve it for Lincoln Memorial. Side out, Lady Railsplitters. Set for the middle, tipped across. Holland responds. Cash for McKinnon in the hole. Dropped it right in the cup. And LMU starting to maybe smell one here as they take a 19-15 lead late in the set. Served by Snyder. Tight ball. Bingle. Great effort by Whitaker. That one at the LMU bench. Nice job by Snyder to hold her composure. Snyder keeps it alive. Cash on the dump. Here's Veith. McKinnon right at the defensive specialist. Holland into the block.
She closes the door.
Wow. That was a long one, too.
Yeah, that was probably a 10-ball rally.
Hardy returns for Coker. Out of the lineup is Veith. And Snyder will serve again for the Lady Railsplitters. 20-15 to the far sideline. Set this time for Bingle. Tough ball at the net for Holland to deal with, and that point's going to go to Coker.
Yeah, she done about all she could do with that one.
The Cobras will get Shaylin Miller back in there, and that'll put Alexis Burles back to serve. She asked for a new ball there. There was a little bit of moisture on that one. You think they're sweating a little bit out there tonight, Mike?
Yeah, they're working hard.
2016. Set for McKinnon into the block. And four hits called on Lincoln Memorial.
You mentioned sweating. The air conditioning, it's nice to have in here now.
You got that right. Holland down line. She's switching it up now, Mike.
Yeah, she's shown good versatility here this evening with her shot selections.
Love the way she's handled this tonight. I mean, it's got to keep the defenders guessing. They don't know really what to do to respond to it.
Well, and she's pounded it, but also hit roll shots as well.
Set near side, Bingle on the attack. Nice dig by Snyder. Brock, hard angle, point Lincoln Memorial. Timeout, Cobras, 22-17. Lady Railsplitters looking to snap a four-match losing streak with a win here tonight over Coker. Back after this on the LMU Sports Network.
Whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Subway of Harrogate and Middlesbrough has your fresh interest at heart. On your way to work, try one of our mouth-watering breakfast sandwiches or flatbread omelets. If it's lunch or dinner you're after, choose from a wide selection of classic, select, or premium sandwiches that are all made specifically to order. Serving a crowd, Subway also has sandwich platters, giant subs, box lunches, and even cookie platters. Be it dine in or carry out, you can eat healthy and eat fresh at Subway. 368 Catawba Avenue in Harrogate and on the corner of the Village Square Mall, Middlesbrough.
Want to remind you again, tomorrow afternoon, Lady Railsplitters get started here with the first serve at 2 o'clock. We'll have pregame coverage beginning at 1:50 on the LMU Sports Network. Join us tomorrow afternoon as Lincoln Memorial plays host to Wingate University. Shelton Collier and the Bulldogs come in as they are nationally ranked and looking to remain once beaten throughout the South Atlantic Conference. Big win tonight for Shelton Collier on the road over in Jefferson City. Again, that's unconfirmed. We believe they won 3-1 over there in that particular match. This one yet to be decided. Bingle McDaniel answers, set for Brock, across and in play. Nice swing by Brock, and LMU one step closer to closing the door on the Cobras, defanging them, if you will.
The fans are trying to get into it. They've been very energetic tonight, and they're smelling a victory.
Here's McDaniel with a serve. Kept alive by Reed, the attack by Bengal out off the back line. That is match point now for Lincoln Memorial. Bengal blocked at the net, McKinnon, and Cash, exclamation point, 25-17. Lincoln Memorial wins it to improve to 4-5 on the year, 2-4 in South Atlantic Conference play, while the Cobras fall to 2-6 and 0-6 in the South Atlantic Conference. We'll take a timeout, and we'll be back to talk with your Old Town Grill University Medical Clinic player of the match, Kiara Holland, and head coach on the LMU Sports Network.
Whether institutional case good or architectural woodwork, Nolan Products Incorporated of Knoxville has been serving East Tennessee, Southwest Virginia, and Southeast Kentucky since 1958. From concept to finish, Nolan Products custom builds to the highest quality standards to meet your facility specifications while using only the finest materials available. Nolan Products has been serving and meeting the needs and requirements of general contractors and architects in East Tennessee and surrounding area for more than 55 years. Nolan Products Incorporated, 912 Forsyth Street, Northeast, Knoxville.
Pinnacle Performance Physical Therapy wants you to know you have a choice where to receive physical and occupational therapy. We take an individualized approach to treating people of all ages. Our therapist's goal is to assist all patients by reaching their pinnacle performance in school, work, and play. We have state-of-the-art equipment such as our Alter-G anti-gravity treadmill, used to rehabilitate injuries and pain throughout the body's lower extremities. Contact us for an appointment at 423-869-9923. Pinnacle Performance Physical Therapy, 362 Catalpa Avenue, Harrogate.
The Quarter Pounder with Cheese. A juicy, simply seasoned patty seared to perfection. Having one next to you can be a little distracting. In fact, it's so beefy and cheesy that... wait a minute. What was I just saying?
Now at McDonald's, get two classic Quarter Pounders with Cheese for only $4. Two great sandwiches for a price you'll be loving.
It's the Old Town Grill.
The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family, more than friends. Bring a hearty appetite. Because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
Whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Subway of Harrogate and Middlesboro has your fresh interest at heart. On your way to work, try one of our mouth-watering breakfast sandwiches or flatbread omelets. If it's lunch or dinner you're after, choose from a wide selection of classic, select, or premium sandwiches that are all made specifically to order. Serving a crowd, Subway also has sandwich platters, giant subs, box lunches, and even cookie platters. Be it dine-in or carry-out, you can eat healthy and eat fresh at Subway. 368 Catawba Avenue in Harrogate and on the corner of the Village Square Mall, Middlesboro.
Pinnacle Performance Physical Therapy wants you to know you have a choice where to receive physical and occupational therapy. We take an individualized approach to treating people of all ages. Our therapist's goal is to assist all patients by reaching their pinnacle performance in school, work, and play. We have state-of-the-art equipment such as our Alter-G anti-gravity treadmill, used to rehabilitate injuries and pain throughout the body's lower extremities. Contact us for an appointment at 423-869-9923. Pinnacle Performance Physical Therapy, 362 Catalpa Avenue, Harrogate.
Welcome back to the Mary Mars Gymnasium. Lady Railsplitters win it here tonight, 3-1. They win the opening set, 25-18. Fall in set two, 26-24. Win sets 3-4, 25-14 and 25-17. Your Old Town Grill, University Medical Clinic player of the match, Kiara Holland. Kiara joins us now here at courtside. And I tell you, Kiara, it seemed like wherever you were hitting from tonight over there on that left side, whether it was across the grain or down line, you were knocking it out of the park.
I don't know what to say. I mean, I just try my best.
Well, absolutely. Talk about, you know, this has been a tough road stretch for you guys. It started with a loss here four matches ago before tonight's match. You went on the road, three tough matches on the road. Got to be tough to play when you drop three or four straight like that.
Yeah, it's pretty tough, but, I mean, it's part of the game. You lose some, you win some.
You've been, you know, the last time we saw you play here in the Mary Mars Gymnasium, over on the far side, when you try to go across the grain with it, seemed like you were having a hard time keeping it in. Tonight, no doubt about it. I mean, they were all in there. And then right about the time they started keying on you on that diagonal attack, you went down line with it, and it seemed like they just never could quite figure out what you were doing.
My teammates called it, and I tried to hit it.
She's a woman of short words, Mike. Help me out here.
I'm working. Kira, you know, tonight you had a double-double. You guys really worked hard. It looked like really the effort of minimizing the unforced errors.
Right.
You could see you guys really working on it. But also, too, you guys really worked hard at the net. You guys were doing a great job of blocking. How does that work with you guys with a lot of communication and your footwork? You guys spend a lot of time working on that. You know, give us a little input on how that works.
We definitely do. Practice a lot of blocking drills, a lot of transitioning. It's hard work, but when you do it right, that's what happens.
I'm going to put you on the spot here just a little bit. How much in practice does Coach Michael stress serve, receive, and reducing the unforced errors?
A lot. We talk about it almost every day.
Kira, one thing that we've seen thus far this season at home, tell us how it feels to play in Mary Mars when you've got such good support from your fellow student athletes and faculty and staff and playing in this confines, and it gets crazy in here.
Yeah. It's pretty great. I mean, this gym, everyone thinks it's small, but it's small and it echoes really well. So when we have the crowd going and we're loud, it's really nice to play in. It's a great gym.
Early in the match, you were neck and neck with Tone Gill for the player of the match should we go on to win. Tone tonight playing on the middle, I'm not a big knowledgeable guy when it comes to volleyball, but you don't really see somebody of her stature playing in the middle like that, but she elevates so well and just kind of hangs there.
Yeah, we always talk about what she would look like if she was on the outside just hanging up there, but she's pretty special with her legs.
And if she had another 6 inches, she probably wouldn't be at Lincoln Memorial. So, you know, no ill intentions intended. She would be Division I somewhere. Hey, congratulations. Great win tonight. Great performance.
Thank you.
All right, Kiara Holland. Mike, any final comments?
No, great job tonight and good luck tomorrow.
Thank you.
All right, Kiara Holland, our Old Town Grill University Medical Clinic player of the match. We'll take a brief timeout. We'll be back with Jenny Michael as the Lady Railsplitters win it tonight 3-1 over Coker College here in Harrogate.
It's the Old Town Grill.
The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family, more than friends. Bring a hearty appetite. Because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
Whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Subway of Harrogate and Middlesbrough has your fresh interest at heart. On your way to work, try one of our mouth-watering breakfast sandwiches or flatbread omelets. If it's lunch or dinner you're after, choose from a wide selection of classic, select, or premium sandwiches that are all made specifically to order. Serving a crowd, Subway also has sandwich platters, giant subs, box lunches, and even cookie platters. Be it dine-in or carry-out, you can eat healthy and eat fresh at Subway. 368 Catawba Avenue in Harrogate and on the corner of the Village Square Mall, Middlesbrough.
Putters win it tonight to snap a four-match losing streak. They win it in four. Again, the final set score is 25-18. They win it in the opening set. They fall in set two, 26-24. Win in set three, 25-14. And close the door on the Cobras in the fourth set, 25-17. Jenny Michael, head coach of the Lady Railsplitters, joins us now. And, Coach, I tell you, they tend to win things in a very dramatic fashion. They're not one to close the door in three, but they seem to want to go four or five in these things, and I know that's probably not what you're looking for.
Well, no. I mean, our girls definitely, they love to play this sport. That's part of what we all enjoy. But, you know, sometimes it would be nice if we could expand on an opportunity to play one or two less sets and still be victorious. I'm trying to communicate with them that's still fun. So
many areas tonight that I thought you guys had improved since the last time we saw you play. Of course, you've played four matches since that time, or actually three matches since that time, all on the road. But I thought you had a big outside presence on the outside hitting position. Tone Gill got you started on the middle early. I think Allison McKinnon kind of picked up the torch later on and picked it up there. But you had a big presence at the net on the blocking end of things tonight too.
Absolutely. One of the keys for us is, you know, and our girls know this, it's not disrespectful at all, but we don't have an all-star. You know, in any given night, we have people that can step up, and one of our keys is being consistent, having more than one option offensively. And tonight, you know, to see that, I mean, we had three girls in double digits and a couple that were knocking on the door. I mean, that kind of being the ability to spread the offense across all three positions on the net at any given time, that's what's going to make us dangerous.
Coach, you stressed, as you say, you're blocking. I thought your scrappiness, your ball control, extended a lot of rallies and gave Abby a lot of different options tonight. She spread the ball around, and you had a lot of hitters come through as far as attacks and done some nice work on the court as far as putting a lot of kills away.
Yes, looking at our offense, one of our big things that we were talking about. Really this whole season, but we've really been paying attention to it, especially since Tuesday night at Carson Newman, was just offensive efficiency. You know, and with the exception of that second set, which we lost because we were dumb and made a lot of errors. I mean, the second set, we had as many hitting errors as the other team did in the first two sets combined. That's not efficient. That's not being successful. That's not going to get us to where we want to be. But looking down and seeing that other than that second set, we're hitting 200 or above, I don't think we've done that all year. If we have, it's been when we've been successful. And when we don't hit above that mark, then it just, that's when I get grumpy.
Well, another key contribution tonight as well is we minimized our unforced errors. As you say, if we take away those unforced errors in set two, mm-hmm. you know, we did a good job of capitalizing on a lot of things tonight.
Absolutely. You know, only four attack errors in the last two sets, and it's no surprise that those two were, you know, if you're here, you feel it. You feel the energy. You know, even though the first set, the score, you look at it, and it's like, oh, okay, like they won. It really wasn't a convincing win. The second set, you know, we crudded that one away and, you know, lost that one, had way too many unforced errors. But then that third and fourth set, you could feel it. You could feel it in the gym. You could feel it on the court. Things were clicking. You know, we were terminating, we were scoring. You know, even when we had an error, for the most part, they were aggressive errors. And that's something that we've been trying to communicate with the girls, too, is, you know, we can live with an aggressive mistake, but it's being tentative and being tight that we're trying to reduce that and just flow, just be better.
Well, there was some heavy speculation early in the match that that you had put springs in Holland's shoes and then injected helium into Tone Gill's leg. So is there anything to that rumor?
They came like that, so it was done before I got a hold of them.
I tell you what, they're a lot of fun to watch. I want to point out some defensive play tonight as well, though. And you know, the defensive end of the game is really an area that a lot of times doesn't get credit. Now, we had some great performances up the net by a lot of individuals tonight who really teamed up. But the little Whitaker girl there that plays the defensive specialist, I tell you what, she is all over the place. I know if you can get her to use that other arm sometimes, it'll be a better day, but she's really a spark.
Yes, we had a very stern conversation in front of her mother, actually, and I just wanted to know, you know, why can she make these unbelievable, impossible plays? She doesn't just touch the ball. She's making digs that are going to target or going to somebody that can, you know, put us in some sort of, you know, respectable out-of-position or out-of-system offense. But then some of the easy stuff, it's like, ball going backwards, ball going left, ball going right. So, you know, there's one word that I have for her, and it's freshman.
Well, you know, I seem to remember a conversation you and I had some time ago. They're not freshmen when they hit the floor. They're all the same age.
I
caught you on your own words right
well,
there, Coach.
Yeah.
All right. Big match for you tomorrow, but no bigger than any other one that you're going to play this year. Just another opponent. But you've got a nationally ranked opponent coming in here in Wingate. I think they were unconfirmed winners tonight over Carson Newman 3-1 in Jeff City.
Interesting. You know, I wondered how that matchup was going to play out on Friday or tonight because Carson Newman was one in the conference going into it. We had a chance to see them on Tuesday, and Wingate, you know, was going to be hungry for sure because – you know, one of their few losses last year was at the hands of Carson Newman, and that's a good rivalry that they've got going on, a lot of chirping and whatnot. So, it'll be interesting. We get a quick turnaround, an opportunity to, you know, for the first time this season, possibly go 2-0 at home, and that's something that we're going to be working hard to try to accomplish.
Coach, great effort tonight. Hopefully we can keep some of that in tune and bring that same spirit tomorrow.
Absolutely. We hope so as well.
Best of luck tomorrow, Coach. We're looking forward to that one. All right. Again, your Lady Railsplitters win it here tonight in four. They win 25-18 to open the match, lose 26-24, win 25-14, and win 25-17 again to improve to 4-5 on the year, 2-4 in the SAC. Tomorrow afternoon, they'll face the big dog. That's Wingate University. 2 o'clock first serve here in Harrogate. We'll have pregame coverage beginning at 1:50 here on the LMU Sports Network. For everybody behind the scenes of Lincoln Memorial University Volleyball, I'm Rusty Peace.
And I'm Mike Smith.
We'll see you tomorrow afternoon right here on the Lincoln Memorial University Sports Network.